हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू नॉलेज गैलेक्सी टू रीडिस्कवर द बेसिक्स विथ मयंक तिवारी, ए प्रीमियर कोचिंग एंड ट्रेनिंग चैनल डेडिकेटेड टू मेटलर्जी स्टडीज एंड कंसल्टेंसी, एस्टैब्लिश्ड टू कैटर द नीड्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स डिग्री डिप्लोमा एंड AMIIM मेटलर्जी कंपिटिटिव एंड रिक्रूटमेंट एग्जाम्स फॉर गेट सेल एंड वेरियस अदर गवर्नमेंट एंड प्राइवेट सेक्टर कंपनीज metallurgical industries and whosoever seeking knowledge and information about various subjects and topics of metallurgy, operational process optimization, productivity improvement analysis, concepts like 5S, total productive maintenance, TPM, quality circle, QC, root cause analysis, RCA, ISO systems, QMS, EMS and OSHA, प्रैक्टिकल एंड इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन इंग्लिश रिटन एंड स्पोकन टू इम्पार्ट प्रैक्टिकल इंडस्ट्रियल नॉलेज एज पर योर स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स वाया टेलर मेड प्रेजेंटेशंस ट्रेनिंग सेशंस फॉर योर कलीग्स एम्प्लॉयज एंड स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज कॉन्टेक्ट मी ऑन knowledgegalaxy26@gmail.com और व्हाट्सएप मी ऑन +91 99 071 44 101 फॉर शेड्यूलिंग एंड ऑर्गेनाइजिंग द सेशंस एट योर प्लेस और वाया वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग. इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फेरोलाइज लिक्विड मेटल एंड स्लैग टैपिंग कास्टिंग एंड डिस्पोजल प्रैक्टिसेस विच आर वेरी मच कॉमन इन मोस्ट ऑफ द फेरोलाइज प्रोड्यूसिंग प्लांट्स. So let's start the video. Liquid metal and slag are collected inside the furnace hearth after reduction and smelting of the oxides of the ore. They trickle down the coke bed below the arc zone of the electrodes. This trickling action is very much necessary and important as it enhances the reduction of the oxides because of enhanced surface area of contact of liquid metal and slag with the coke bed. This is an schematic representation of the liquid metal and slag being trickling down below the arc zone of electrodes and below the coke bed. The liquid metal and slag collected below the coke bed always remains in severe circulation churning action due to heavy arcing from the electrodes when power supply is on. This further enhances the refining of the impure liquid metal and slag because of the chemical equilibrium constantly changing. When sufficient liquid metal and slag gets collected on the hearth based on the power consumption recorded in the furnace control room through energy meters readings, the control room operator asks the tapping crew for starting of the tapping operation. The tap hole is opened by oxygen lancing through mild steel lancing pipes. The liquid metal and slag comes out of the furnace simultaneously from the tap hole and flow through the runner launder to the skimmer dam arrangement. The skimmer dam arrangement enables the separation of liquid metal and slag due to specific gravity difference where the liquid metal and slag are casted in sand beds alone. Casting of liquid metal and slag in sand beds alone was an old practice, but it is still being used by some producers. This practice is cheaper in cost, both installation and operating, but it causes generation of larger amount of slag and sand contaminated alloy, thereby reducing the overall yield of the product and further increases the cost of the product as more time consuming labor and jigging is required for the cleaning and separation of these slag and sand contaminated alloy. The new and more popular practice of separation of liquid metal and slag is the use of cast iron pans or molds for collection and solidification of the liquid metal and slag. The liquid metal, being heavier, settles at the bottom and is guided to flow into the consecutive cast iron mounds along with the lighter slag overflowing on it, and the slag is collected in either sand beds or metal pans. The liquid metal and slag cakes are left for cooling and solidification. This practice, although being costlier than the sand bed casting practice due to the use of cast iron molds and its preparation activities, is preferred because it enables better and cleaner separation of liquid metal and slag, thereby increasing the overall yield of the product and reduced labor and time for its breaking, sizing and packing, along with the reduced amount of slag and sand contaminated alloy. Tapping operation under progress. As can be seen in this picture, the tapping operation is under progress for a liquid metal and slag furnace. The liquid metal and slag are coming simultaneously out of the tap hole and comes via runner and rounder to the cast iron molds kept consecutively and flows to the next mold simultaneously. Liquid metal and slag after tapping left for cooling and solidification. As can be seen from this picture, the liquid metal and slag are left for cooling and solidification after tapping. When liquid metal and slag flow through the tap hole stops, the tap hole is closed with mud buds mixed with tamping paste powder as much deep as possible. The tap hole so closed gets heated and hardens because of the heat from inside the furnace. The tamping paste powder helps in burning off the mud when oxygen is launched for opening up the tap hole next time. The runners and rounders are also dressed with sand. The cast iron molds are dressed with sodium silicate, mixed sand and coated with lime prior to each tapping. Care must be taken to ensure that the runners, rounders and cast iron pans gets dried after dressing with moistened sand. This is important to eliminate boiling action when liquid metal flows through them. In this video picture, runners and rounders and cast iron molds preparation is under progress. This is one picture which shows well prepared cast iron molds and sand beds coated with lime, well dried up, well prepared. After solidification and prior to getting very cold, the metal cakes and slag cakes are lifted with the help of EOT cranes and placed on the specified boxes for shifting to the finished products yards for further breaking, sizing and packing as per the requirements of the customers and for further use in the furnace. The breaking, sizing and packing of the products is semi-mechanized. The product is finally dispatched to the customers. This picture shows solidified metal and slag cakes being lifted by EOT cranes. This is a dumper ready for shifting solidified metal and slag cakes to the finished products yards. As can be seen in this product, that solidified metal and slag cakes are dumped onto the finished products yards, are being cooled, and then their breaking and sizing activities starts. For breaking and sizing of solidified metal and slag cakes, semi-mechanized or fully mechanized crushers can also be used, as can be seen from this picture. During the breaking and sizing of the finished products, a several lot of amount of fines are generated, which are required to be screened before packing of the final products. As can be seen from this picture, packing and weighment of the final product is under progress. This is as per customer's requirement. Normally, the packing is done in 40 or 50 kg bags or 1 ton jumbo bags. As can be seen from this picture, loading of packed products is under progress. As can be seen in this picture, jigging of semi-finished products is under progress. Semi-finished products are those products which are basically slag and sand contaminated alloy and the products after primary crushing. Hope you liked the content and found the video worth. So please don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. Also remember to press the bell icon so that you can get the notification of the new videos promptly. So friends, this is all for this present video. See you in the next video. Keep watching my videos. I have prepared them by my varied experience of over 15 years. Please do visit all videos of my channel and watch them till the end. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Thanks.